Okay, let's do this. Hello YouTube, this is Walsh with Canoy. The Intel new NUC 12 Pro is available in fall 2022, starting at £749 in UK. Equipped with the Intel Gen 12 CPU with the new big little CPU architecture. The Canoy I had today is the i5 version. The i5-1240P provides 12 cores of CPUs and 60 threads of processing power. With the XDI GPU comes 80 execution units. It also has a i7-1260P variant equipped with the same 12 cores and 60 threads design with a higher clocking and a slightly better XDI GPU with 96 execution units. Both i5 and i7's 12 cores include 4 performance cores, aka P cores, with hyper-threaded technologies and 8 efficiency core, E cores, which are a huge upgrade from the last year's NUC 11 series with only 4 cores and 8 threads. Mostly Canoy also had a lower-end i3-1220P version with 2 fewer P cores, making it a 10 cores, 12 threads alternative. One of the noticeable changes from its predecessor is NUC 12 Wall Street Canoy cancelled the USB-C ports from the front, making both front-facing ports USB-A, which I'm not a big fan of. Both USB ports are running at USB 3.2 10 gigs per second. We also have a 3.5mm jack for our audio devices and the power button. On the back of the NUC, Intel NUC never disappointed us by providing various port selection. We have a 12 to 20 watt DC jack, which we might able to power this NUC by USB power delivery. i3 model has a 19 watts power budget on the PSU, which should be able to companion with a 100 watt JN adapter with USB-C to DC 20 watts cable comfortably. i5 and i7 on the other hand have a 120 watts power budget on the PSU. In this case, you may not want to power this NUC via USB power delivery at the moment. Since I'm using this NUC as a Homelab server and stability is my primary concern, I will stick with the original big old-fashioned PSU that currently comes with the package. We hope Intel in the future can provide us with a version that can power with the Type-C directly. We also have two Thunderbolt 4 USB 4 Type-C connectors here, providing not only one but two 40GB PCIe connectivity, which enables amazing expandability to this NUC. You can add 10GB Ethernet, external GPU enclosure, more SSDs, 8K displays, or even connect with some Thunderbolt docks, which extend pretty much everything you can imagine. Many Thunderbolt 4 USB 4 docks also enable the user to expand the Thunderbolt 4 upstream ports to as many as 3 extra ports for up to 40GB for each downstream devices, although it is still sharing the whole 40GB backbones. We have two HDMI 2.0B ports that you can connect up to two 4K 60Hz display here. With all the Thunderbolt and HDMI ports, that means you may connect up to 4 displays at a time. I believe it is where the name Wall Street Canoy come from. NUC 12 also provides 2.5GB Intel i25 multi-gig ports, which is nice as the world is moving to a faster Ethernet connections nowadays, and 2.5GB switch is becoming more and more affordable. The future-proof is always a good thing. We also have one USB 3.2 10GB Type-A port and a USB 2.0 port for your mouse and keyboard on the back. Intel NUC has a tall and slim version. The version we have today is a tall version and comes with an expansion bay, which according to Intel's information, we can potentially expand another 2.5GB Ethernet port and a few more USB ports here. The tall version also have the room to expand with a 2.5-inch SSD, which I will cover later in the session. On the top lid, Intel removed the Qi variant from the last generation, which I think not many people actually using. The NUC Pro series are usually mounted under your desk or behind your monitor, which effectively making the Qi wireless charging have no function at all. The NUC 12 Wall Street Canon doesn't change much on the tablet. It has a big blower fan that cooling the system very well, yet incredibly quiet. Removing four screws, we can have a look at the inside of the NUC. The tall version will have a 2.5-inch hard disk container, which can expand your NUC storage using a 2.5-inch SSD or a cheaper 2.5-inch hard drive option. The first thing we notice on the motherboard side is the Intel AX211 Wi-Fi card sitting on the M.2 key E connector. The Intel AX211 provides 802.11ax 2x2 Wi-Fi 6E with 160MHz channel support and Bluetooth 5.2 connectivity. Maximum Wi-Fi transfer speeds up to 2.4 gigabits per second, basically giving you the best Wi-Fi option currently available on the market. Because it is also a standalone card, not soldered in the motherboard, it also enables you a great lifespan with you can swap the Wi-Fi chipset in the future when anything newer and you want to upgrade. For the SSD, this NUC supports 12280 length Gen 4x4 SSD on its M.2 key M connector. Also downward support to the Gen 3 SSD as well. So the SSD speed won't be the bottleneck of the system. Here is the M.2 2242 key B connector, which is a bit interesting here. This connector provides USB 3.2 SATA SSD or PCIe Gen 3x1 expandability. This means you can expand 2.5 GBE Ethernet ports from here, as I said a couple of minutes before. Or you can install N2242 SATA SSD here if you wish. For the tall version, I don't see why you would like to expand SSD here, as you have a lot cheaper 2.5-inch SATA expandability. For the slim version, since the 2242 SATA SSD is not very common, only if you can find a cheap one on eBay or you already have one. Otherwise, I would pretty much suggest you connect the additional SSD via one of the two super high-speed Thunderbolt 4 USB 4 ports. It could possibly be a better option, especially since we can see a nicer speed on the Thunderbolt port or even just the 10GB USB 3.2 ports. For the RAM, Intel only gives us the option to put in two DDR4 3200MHz RAM up to 64GB in total. I'm quite surprised that Intel does not give us an option on the DDR5 RAM. Although it is still pricey, since the Intel Xe iGPU really relies on the RAM speed, a higher RAM speed is certainly better. If you are going to play games on the NUC using the iGPU, you might want to connect an external GPU for that purpose. Since my angle is using this NUC is to make it a Homelab server handling all of my VMs, test lab, smart home, calculations, and always-on services, I will install 232GB RAM from Micron and a 2TB Gen 4 SSD from Samsung. The model is PM981, an OEM SSD, and it is equivalent to the retail Samsung 980 Pro Gen 4 SSD. So in total, we should get a 12-core 16-thread Homelab server with 64GB of RAM and 2TB of SSD. It sounds nice. I will also install the Windows 10 Enterprise LTSC version 21H2 to the NUC, so it should fully support the Intel Gen 12 Alder Lake CPU. But that will be the next video reviewing the NUC 12 Wall Street Canon. It is it! If you enjoyed the video, like, subscribe, and be sure to hit that bell button to be the first to know when a new video drops. You can also ask me anything in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and until next time, bye.